Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you are all doing well. And have you marked the maps that are asked to you to be done? Yes. So in your previous session, you have learned to mark the 28 states, the union territories, and the SAR countries. Isn't it, children? And we have even learned about the northern mountains, northern plains, and all the physical features. Okay, and today we will be learning about one of the physical feature in very detailed manner. Okay, that is our next lesson that we are learning today is the northern mountains. So children, you are learning today about the northern mountains. The northern mountains are also known as the highest mountains, children. Okay, look at the northern mountains location, children. That is from Jammu Kashmir. You marked like union territories, right? You have marked union territories here. So from Jammu Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh, the northern mountains are located. But these northern mountains are consisting of two groups of mountains. Children, the northern mountains consist of two groups of mountains. That is the greater Himalayas and the Karakoram ranges. So the whole northern mountains, that is from Jammu Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh, they are called northern mountains. But northern mountains consist of the Karakoram ranges and the Himalayas. Okay, the Karakoram ranges, you can see them here, children, in the northern part of India. And the greater Himalaya, the Himalayas, you can see all this area, that is from Jammu Kashmir to Arunachal Pradesh. East-west extension, that is east-to-west extension, the mountains, that is the northern mountains, east-west extension of the northern mountains is 2,400 kilometers. Till now, we are learning northern mountains as a whole. Later on, we will learn about only the Himalayas. Okay, children? So now, the east-west extent of northern mountains is 2,400 kilometers. And the width is like this, children. East-west extension is this, but width is like this. Width is from the, in the north, it is nearly 500 kilometers. So the width varies from north to northeast. Okay, children, north to east, the width varies. Because in the northern part of India, that is where we are having even the Karakoram ranges. So the northern mountains here are, the width is 500 kilometers. But when it comes to eastern part of India, that means from north to the east, by then it extends, the width varies. That is from the north, it is 500 kilometers to 200 kilometers to the east. So it varies, children. Varies means differs, okay? So from 500 kilometers to 200 kilometers. And in these northern mountains, we have the great mountain peaks. Or the highest mountain peaks. One is the Mount Everest, which is located in Nepal. And this Mount Everest is the highest mountain in the world. Mount Everest is the highest mountain in the world. Mountain peak it is. Okay, this is called peak, children. The topmost area of a mountain is called a peak. Okay, so the Mount Everest is the highest mountain in the world and its height is 8,848 meters. Its height is 8,848 meters. And the next mountain that is located in the northern mountains, this is the second highest mountain, children, in the northern mountains. This is the second highest mountain, that is Mount K2. That is Mount K2. K2 is also known as Godwin Austin. Children, Mount K2 is also known as Godwin Austin. Children, here you should remember one thing. Mount Everest is the highest mountain in the world, but Mount K2 is the second highest mountain in the world, but it is the highest mountain in India. That means it is the first highest mountain in India, because even though Mount Everest is the highest in the world, it is not located in India. It is located in Nepal. But Mount K2 is located in Jammu Kashmir. The mountains in the Jammu Kashmir, Mount K2 or Godwin Austin is located. And its height is 8,611 meters. Its height is 8611 meters. But in the northern mountains, so we have some mountaineers climbing over this mountain. Mountaineer, who are mountaineers, children? People who climb mountain are called mountaineers. So these two people are, this is Mr. Hillary, children. He is Sir Edmund Hillary and he is Tenzing Norgay. Is Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay. These two people were the first person that we have is Bachendri Pal. Children, she is the first woman, first Indian woman to climb Mount Everest. She is the first Indian woman. Bachendri Pal was the first Indian woman to climb Mount Everest. And we have one more person called Arjun Vajpayee. We have Arjun Vajpayee. And he is the youngest Indian to climb in Mount Everest. He is the youngest Indian to climb Mount Everest in the year 2010. And Sir Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay climbed the Mount Everest in the 1953. Okay, children. So Arjun Vajpayee is the youngest Indian. Bachendri Pal was the first Indian woman. But those two people, that is Sir Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay, were the first people to climb Mount Everest. Okay, children. Now, in these northern mountains, that is, which consists of the Karakoram ranges and also the Himalayas. Yes, which consists of the Karakoram ranges and the Himalayas, we have some important hill ranges. They are Garo, Kashi, Jaintia, Naga and Mizo. These are some of the important hill ranges that are located in the northern mountains. Northern mountains, children, northern mountains consist of the Karakoram ranges and the Himalayas. Okay, so the Karakoram ranges and the Himalayas. So in these northern mountains, some of the hill ranges are Garo, Kashi, Jaintia, Naga and Mizo. These are some of the important hill ranges. And not very high in the northeast. See, we already know about the width of the mountains. When we learned in the beginning of this session, we learned that in the northern part of northern mountains, the width is nearly 500 kilometers. But whereas by then it reaches to the northeastern part, that is near Arunachal Pradesh, it is only 200 kilometers. And this area where you have, important hill ranges, that is Garo, Kashi, Jaintia, Naga, Mizo, all these, where you have these hill ranges, in this area, the area is covered with a thick forest. And now we are going to learn about the Himalayas. So now we are not going to learn about Karakoram ranges, children. Till now we learned northern mountains as a whole, where you have Karakoram ranges and also the northern mountains. But now we are going to learn only about the Himalayas. Okay, so the Himalayas are divided into three parts. Children, the Himalayas are divided into three parts. The Greater Himalayas, also known as Himadri Range. The Middle or Lesser Himalayas, also known as Himachal Range. And the Lower Himalayas, that is the down part. The Lower Himalayas. Children, you can see the numbers. So the Lower Himalayas are also known as Shivalik Ranges. The Greater Himalayas, also known as Himadri. The Middle or Lesser Himalayas, known as Himachal Ranges. And the Lower Himalayas are known as Shivalik Ranges. Okay, children. So the Greater Himalayas. What is it also known as, children? Yes, it is the Himadri Ranges. It is located to the extreme north. In the previous slide, you saw that it was the topmost area. Okay, children, the topmost area. So it was located to the extreme north and known as Himadri. But here the mountain height ranges from 6,000 meters from the sea level. Children, what is sea level? Like when you learned about plains, we learned that plains are flat lands, right? So sea level is where you have the sea and its own level here. But from the sea level, that is this sea level, to 6,000 meters high, that is where we have the Himadri Range. 6,000 meters high. And the highest range in the Himalayas is Himadrachal. And this Himadri range is covered with the snow throughout the year. Because, children, you know that from the Earth's surface, that means from the sea level, 180 meters if you climb high, 180 meters, okay? For one, every 180 meters, 1 degree Celsius temperature reduces. Do you know that, children? Okay, now let me give you an example. Okay, suppose on this place, like on our place where we are living, suppose the Celsius, you know, every day the weather department will be telling you about the temperature, like today it will be cloudy, or today it will be having the temperature like 25 degrees Celsius, 30 degrees Celsius, 32 degrees Celsius, right? Okay, like that. So if we have 32 degrees Celsius of temperature on the sea level, that is in our area. So from the sea level, 180 meters high. So 180 meters if you climb up. So it will become only 31 Celsius, children. On the Earth's surface, when we have 32 Celsius degrees, but 180 meters if you go high, it will be only 31 Celsius. That means temperature decreases. Even you go little more high, that means 180, one more 180 meters high, then automatically it will become only 30 degrees Celsius. So from the Earth's surface, as you go to the higher areas, the temperature reduces. You might get a doubt, sun is already up, right? Sun is already up on the sky. And when it is falling on the earth, the climate should be hot. And when it is, we are going by up, means it will be more going to closer to the sun. Then why do we have differences in the temperature? Right, children? Did you get that out after my explanation now? Did you? Yes, I'll tell you even that. So as I told you, from the Earth's surface, when you climb 180 meters high, the temperature reduces 1 degree Celsius, I told you, right? So what happens is, if you take a ball, I'll give you just an example. You take a ball, and when you take a ball, what happens? You throw the ball. When you throw the ball, if someone stops to, like, you aimed at a wall, okay? You aimed at a wall. Don't hit the people, children. So you take a ball and aim at a wall. When you throw the ball at a wall, if you stop it in between, the force in the in between area will be less. And it goes because the aim was there. And as we told, Earth is already slanting. Earth is not like, globe is not straight, children. It is slanting little. So Earth's sun rays fall slanting towards the Earth. Okay. So because of that, when we climb up 180 meters high from the sea level, it will be reducing 1 degree Celsius. Clear, children, till here? Okay, let's come back to our topic. So as I told you, Himadri range is the highest mountain range in the Himalayas and 6,000 meters above the sea level. Because of that, the area here or the mountains here are completely covered with the snow throughout the year. That means the whole year, always, whenever you see, whether it is a summer, whether it is a winter, or it is a rainy season, still the mountains here, that is in the Himadri range, are covered with the snow. Okay? So next, because of that, because always the mountains are covered with the snow, this is a glacier, children. Okay? What is a glacier? Let us see. A glacier is a slow-moving mass or river of ice. Children, can you see the ice in the image here? Yes. So what happens is, because of the temperature on the earth, these glaciers, because every time the snow is there on that mountains, right? So when it becomes heavy, or when because of the temperature at times, it starts slowly flowing down. So like this, as it is ice, you can see ice falling down, right? Like that, it falls and forms into glaciers. And these glaciers, when it reaches to the foot of the hills, that means the down part of the hill, that is, then it forms into rivers. These are the rivers that we have in India, which are originating from the Himalayas. So these rivers, you see, Ganga, Yamuna, Indus, Brahmaputra. These are the rivers that originate from Himalayas. Children, that is the reason these rivers have water throughout the year. Because other rivers, like in our areas, we have Godavari, Krishna, Penna, right? All these rivers. but these rivers will dry off during summer season. But the rivers that we have here, that rivers that we learned that they are originating from the Himalayas, that is River Ganga, River Yamuna, River Indus, and River Brahmaputra, these rivers are perennial rivers. What are the children? Perennial rivers. Perennial rivers mean the rivers that have water throughout the year. Because always there is snow on the mountains, so always the snow will be falling down like glaciers, and the snow will be melting down and form the water. So always they have water. Whereas other rivers, that is Krishna, Godavari, Penna, Musi, Tungabhadra, all these rivers are seasonal rivers. That means if it rains, so only when it rains they will have water. Other season, that is the dry seasons, they will have, they may dry up at some time, but if in that particular year if there is a, there are heavy rains, then automatically there will be little water even during summer. But these rivers, that is all these rivers that I told you, which originated from the Himalayas, have water throughout the year. They have water throughout the year. Next that we are going to learn is Middle or Lesser Himalayas. That is Middle or Lesser Himalayas. These mountains, that is Middle or Lesser Himalayas, are also known as Himachal Range. Middle or Lesser Himalayas are also known as Himachal Range. But these Himachal Range are not as high as the Greater Himalayas. Okay, children? So the Himachal Range is not as high as the Greater Himalayas. But these Himalayas, that is the Middle or Lesser Himalayas, covered with a thick forest. Whereas in the Greater Himalayas, the climate is always very cold because always they have snow, right? So it is very difficult for the plants to grow or even for the animals to live or for the people. Even mountaineers, when they climb, they carry artificial oxygen children. Like they carry the oxygen cylinders. You know, as even the temperature reduces, level of oxygen also reduces when you go to the higher areas. Okay, so in the Greater Himalayas, these trees cannot grow, people and animals cannot live. But whereas in the Middle Himalayas or Lesser Himalayas or the Himachal Range, the area is covered with a thick forest. And in this thick forest, you can see these trees. They are the oak trees, pine trees, and fir trees. These are the important trees that we find in the Lesser Himalayas. Okay, children? The next, even in the Lesser Himalayas, on the mountain foods, mountain steps, they cultivate tea plantations. Tea plantations, you know, children, you might have seen your parents drinking tea. As children, you should not drink tea, children. So don't have tea. It is not good for your health. So you can have milk, but not tea. But tea is used by the people, okay? So tea plantations are there in the Lesser Himalayas or the Middle Himalayas. And the climate in this area. Children, summers are cool and pleasant. Summers are cool and pleasant. That's why during summer season, generally, we also go to hill stations, right? Like Shimla, Manali, Ooty, Kodaikanal. Yes, all these are the hill stations. So generally, people go there during summer season to escape from the heat. Okay, to escape from the heat means in our area where we are living, Hyderabad is in a plateau region. So automatically the climate will be hot during summer season. Even coastal areas will be hot. So in the hill stations, the climate will be little cool and pleasant. That's why during summer seasons, we generally visit hilly areas, right? Hill areas like Ooty, Kodaikanal, all these areas. We like to visit so that we can escape the heat of the sun. So here, the climate in the Greater, Middle or Lesser Himalayas, summers are cool and pleasant. But winters are very cold. Winters are very cold. Now, here we even have valleys. What is a valley, children? A valley is a low area of land between hills or mountains, typically with a river or a stream flowing through it. You can see the image, children, here. See, this is a hill, and in between you have a place, lowland, where the water is flowing. So this is a valley. Okay, so valleys are actually so beautiful to look at. Okay, what is a valley, children? A low area of land between hills or mountains, typically with a river, a stream flowing through it. Okay, children? So we have some important valleys located in the middle or lesser Himalayas. They are Shimla, Manali, Nainital, Almora, Mussoorie, Dharmashala, Gangtok, and Darjeeling. Okay, children? These are the important valleys that are located in the great middle or lesser Himalayas. And now we will see about a mountain pass. So what is a mountain pass? It is A mountain pass is a navigable route through a mountain range or over a ridge. Children, look at here. This is the mountain pass. That means we have the mountain, this side and this side. But actually, this is one mountain. In between the mountain, we have a lane, a road. We have a road, a path. This is called mountain pass. This is called mountain pass because we are passing through the mountain. That's why it is called as mountain pass. So in northern mountains, that is especially in the middle or lesser Himalayas or the Himachal range, we have Rohtang Pass, which is in Himachal Pradesh, and we have Nathula, that is located in Sikkim, and Bondila, that is located in Arunachal Pradesh. So these are the mountain passes that we have in the middle or lesser Himalayas. Okay, children, did you understand the lesson? Yes. So let's recap once again. So we have learned about the northern mountains, which consist of the Karakoram ranges and the Himalayas. Okay. In the Karakoram ranges that are located in the northern mountains, that is the northern part of India, which are located in Jammu Kashmir. But when you come to the Himalayas, Himalayas are divided into three parts. The greater Himalayas, also known as Himadri, the middle or lesser Himalayas, also known as Himachal range, and the lower Himalayas, also known as Shivalik range. So we have learned about the climate of the two areas, that is the lower Himalayas and also the greater Himalayas. Whereas in greater Himalayas, because the climate is always cold, completely cold, covered with the snow, very high above the sea level, because of that we cannot cultivate or we cannot grow any trees, and even people or animals cannot live in that area. But when you come to lower Himalayas, or lesser or middle Himalayas, that is Himachal range, we can see, we have seen people cultivating even tea plantations, right? Tea plantations were grown. We have seen different trees like fir, pine, deodar, all these trees that were grown there. Yes. Okay, children, do the given worksheet. Go through once again all the slides and see that you understand in a proper way. That means you should understand properly so that it will be easy for you to remember the things. Okay, children, thank you. Have a great day.